Hey, what's up, guys? This is Team Hard Life Captain Alberto Zertuche, and I'm at Indianola Pier. We're here dropping off the gear, but while we're waiting for them to print out the rest of the barcodes, we figure we wait a line or two. Yeah, because we're limited to one rod per person. So, we got our two rods for me and Mr. Tony. So, we're going to get them out there, get the underwater cameras, and see if we can see anything. Be pretty cool to hook up a monster drum during the daylight, especially with the drum tournament coming up this weekend. Don't miss out on that. If you haven't gotten with Team Captain Eric Hernandez, and Captain Eric Hernandez, should I say, get with him to get in the tournament. It's going to be a real nice one. There's a lot of money up for grabs, a lot of prizes coming in, and it's pretty awesome. So let's get to it real quick. Gotta bite.
I got a lot of stress on my mind. It's a nice day to go. Yeah, I got a line. I'ma call the whole team.
A lot of people were asking me, how do I rig up my pantyhose with the crab? I've done several videos before, but I'm going to do a little updated one real quick. These are all frozen crab. So, actually, they're really good condition. They're not real soft. But to get a lot of the flavor out, what I'll do, want the pinchers because those are the excellent bait for later. You know. And I'm going to rip off the shell. So I want maximum bait disbursement like that. And you can pile on the legs in there or use them separately. I've done that as well. Let's open up the pantyhose for food.
Can't see. Don't see a face.
Oh. There we go. Maybe that's better. Now, I'm going to wrap my pantyhose around it. And then tie it up. See, all the juice is already coming right out of it. It's good, but I want it in the water. And then you cut the tag end off. Which means you can use the rest for your next bait and go from there. Now, since we are going to put the underwater cameras on, definitely put one of those out here. Water's semi-clear, so get this out there. And what I'll do is, down here on this bottom ribcage, I'll go through one of the leg ports right there. And then as I'm pulling the shell, that's what happens with frozen crab, it's real brittle. And I'm trying to hold it like this so I don't drop out of the juices. I'm gonna get it rigged up, cast it out, see how it goes. This is Tony's crab we just cracked open, so again, wrap it all up. Tie it down. And cut. Good to go. So as you can see, this one pantyhose, I'll be able to do like 5 or 6 crab. Oh yeah, we got our food now. I got a Swiss mushroom burger. He just got a regular mushroom burger. And yeah, I got curly fries. He got onion rings, even though he don't like onion rings.
Not in my burger.
So, when y'all do come to Indianola, make sure to get some of their food. It's really, really good. while we're out here watching our rods, getting some food.
No, it's not a lunch date.
You don't like me.
Well, people start asking.
Yeah, our lack of rod will go off right when we're eating. That's good. Like I said, let's see. You on? He's on. There we go. I told you it was gonna happen. Oh yeah, already on the surface too. Yeah, we can do it in the middle. Thank you.
Oh yeah, he's easily 38. Got it, bro. Good catch, man. Yes, sir.
Did you say hola?
Good.
No,
good. Yes, sir. Hey, show us the bait real quick so we can show them that we can reuse the bait. Oh, you're good. I was right around you.
Okay,
you're good.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll put it on our YouTube channel. It's called Team Hard Life. Hard Life. Team Hard Life, like my shirt. So what we'll do now is we'll rehook it and reuse it. Oh, no worries. Y'all have a good one. No.
I've been up to Florida a couple times, but I've been up there once at least, but it's not official there.
Yeah. Goes. I'll be reusing it again.
He does a lot of YouTube for knowledge and whatnot, and what to do, what not to do.
That's what I was looking for.
Yeah. Team Hard Life on YouTube. It has it all already.
He has a lot of those videos on
back to eating. We got like one or two bites each and that was it.
I seen it
bubbling,
but I thought it was just the water.
Yeah, it literally just happened though, because I was looking that way. I looked down and looked up. And
that's my turn.
Watching the water, watching our ride.